We're headed down the home stretch with only 3 weeks between now and the end of the regular season. Welcome to the pregame show. I'm Ted Madden. Horn and Mesquite met in the district's marquee matchup last Friday, and it was first responders night at Memorial Stadium. Legend Bay had another big game for the Jaguars, and he got it started midway through the first quarter with a 53-yard touchdown run. Bay finished with 118 rushing yards on 11 carries. Mesquite came back with a sneaky touchdown pass. Watch closely as Armand Cleaver shovels it to Preston Jackson for the score. In the final seconds before halftime, the Skeeters had a more traditional touchdown pass from Sermaje Wallace to Jeremiah Johnson. Johnson also threw a TD pass later in this game. The Jags blew things open in the third quarter when sophomore running back LaVon Morton scored 2 of his 3 touchdowns. He rushed for 125 yards, and Horn gets its first district win, 48-27. Next up for the Jags is a trip to East Texas to play Tyler Legacy, and this is a game Horn has to win. Legacy is 1-5 and coming off a blowout loss to Rockwall Heath. The Skeeters are home to play Royse City Friday night at Hanby Stadium. This is a big game for both teams who are looking to get back into the playoff hunt. North Mesquite was home to play Lufkin, and I love this play design. Kamar Johnson motions in, then cuts out on his route, and he's wide open for the easy touchdown pass from Luke Cedar. But Lufkin won this game by the final of 25-7. Next up for the Stallions is the number 2 team in the state in Class 5A Division 1, the Longview Lobos. North will be back home next Thursday to take on 10th-ranked Forney. Poteet is on the road to play Greenville, whose head coach, Randy Jackson, coached for the 2010 Pirates team that was just inducted into our Hall of Honor. West Mesquite takes on Tyler, 7 o'clock at Memorial Stadium. It's a good night to catch the Wranglers at home because their next 2 games will be on the road. The District 12-5A cross-country meet was earlier this week, and Mesquite ISD showed out. They ran on a track just south of the Jesse Owens Sports Complex in South Dallas. On the girls' side, the first 12 to cross the finish line were all from Mesquite, with Talyn Leek from North finishing first, ahead of her teammate Abigail Ortega and Poteet freshman Yarity Munoz. The top 10 runners will advance to regionals. On the boys' side, 9 of the top 10 finishers were all from Mesquite ISD, led by Adam Fuentes from West, followed by North freshman Joshua Loera.
After the second mile, that's when I started pushing it to get away. Throughout the summer, I was just pushing myself towards my limits. Without that, I wouldn't have been here winning back-to-back district champion.
At first, this was just like I'm just here for track. I'm not taking cross seriously. And like thinking about this race now and then going into track season, like it just changes my whole perspective that all it takes is hard work.
Mesquite ISD brought home both district championship trophies, West on the boys' side and North on the girls' side. And all 3 Mesquite schools in District 12-5A, North, West, and Poteet, both boys and girls, all will advance to the regional meet on Monday, October 23rd at Lynn Creek Park in Grand Prairie. That's it for the pregame show. Thank you for supporting Mesquite ISD Athletics, and enjoy your game.